God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's go in the peace to serve and love the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. you be seated for a word or two from the rector.
This morning to do one of the important activities in this year of the consecrated life. As the Archdiocese of Lusaka, the religious together, we gather in order to thank the Lord for our lives, for our commitment to the Lord, and would like to do this so forth that we interrupt this act, and then thereafter we continue with our activities in the afternoon. As you know, this year of the consecrated life is going to end next year on 2nd February. There will be another symposium next year. The date is not yet confirmed, and the venue, so that we move on nicely. So today, as we gather this morning, you are more than welcome to St. Bonaventure. And we ask the spirit of St. Bonaventure and also the spirit of St. Ignatius of Antioch to intercede for us, that the activities of today be blessed and be blessed fully. So to all of you, the superiors, and also those other invited guests, you are sincerely welcome as I call upon the many celebrant Father Christopher, the parish priest of Christ Redeemer, to lead us into this Eucharistic celebration. Shall we be seated? Shall we stand up?
In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, as we together in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, through the intercession of St. Bonaventure and St. Ignatius of Antioch, may they help us to go more closely to God and as well to one another, that we are able to truly experience the friendship as we share the Word of God with the world, and one another. As we acknowledge our own limitations, our own shortcomings and sins and failures in these matters, we ask for pardon and peace. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Ever-living God, who adorn the sacred body of your church with the confession of the holy martyrs, grant, we pray, that just as the glorious passion of St. Ignatius of Antioch, which we celebrate today, brought him eternal splendor, so may it be for us an unending protection through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Acts chapter 2, reading from verses 42 to 47. They devoted themselves to the teaching of the apostles and to the communal life, to the breaking of the bread and to the prayers. All came upon everyone, and many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their property and possessions and divide them among all according to each one's need. Every day they devoted themselves to meeting together in the temple area and to the breaking of bread in their homes. They ate their meals with exhortation and sincerity of heart, praising God and enjoying favor with all the people. And every day the Lord added to their number those who were being saved.